all the locations, why did you choose this particular location for your hotel?
See, this is a very strategic location if you look at it in a way that the airport is not too far from here. Then, you know, the entire Aerocity, which has a huge surplus of rooms, that is not too far away. In addition to that, all the premium banqueting locations other than my own are situated very close by. So, in a gap of about 4 or 5 kilometers, all the other premium banquets are also located here. In addition to my own banquet, my own very premium banquets, the Ritz and the Riviera also here. So it's a very strategic and a very central location. So I'm able to capture a lot of business, not only of the FITs coming from the airport, but the surplus of the rooms from the Aerocity, plus the banqueting from the other venues as well.
What unique features do you offer to your customers? Why do you feel that people should choose this hotel over any other hotel?
There are a lot of hotels. The Aerocity is full of hotels, and a lot of other competitors down the line also have hotels. When we introduced this hotel, the first thing that we had in mind was to make a hotel specific for weddings. So, which means, does not mean that the other hotels do not have weddings in it. But when one is doing a wedding, his requirements are very, very specific. And at the same time, they're very vague. And a lot of small spaces are required because of the n number of small ceremonies that are attached to a wedding. So when we were designing this hotel, what came to our mind was there are enough hotels offering MICE and conferences, but there is no hotel which has been built in a way that can take care of all the small needs associated with a wedding and the various ceremonies. So we thought of making it as a wedding destination hotel. And that's how Udman was made.
So you call yourself as a wedding
hotel? Yes, we are a boutique wedding destination resort, so to say.
So in a year, how many weddings do you host?
I guess all of us know that in a year, there are about 40 or 45 wedding dates that get culled out from a Hindu wedding calendar. And we are lucky enough to host at least about 50 to 60 weddings through the year in this, where it's a typical residential wedding package that happens over 2 days.
Other than this, if you could just tell me about your F&B offerings.
See, F&B is a very integral and a very important part of any hotel. Now, when I say that we do a lot of destination or residential weddings, and off lately, mixed cultured weddings are also the trend, you know, with parents having left the choice to the children. And all of us know that we have the freedom to choose partners of any religion now. So having said that, mixed cultured weddings. Now, when you say mixed cultured wedding, sounds easy, but when it comes to the food part, the two different parties have a lot of intricate food demands, and the team here needs to be very, very hands-on. And me per se as a person, I like to call myself as a culture specialist, because having traveled so wide and far within India, I understand a lot of cultures and languages and the different traditions that are required. And accordingly, every tradition has its own taste and food demands, which, thanks to the beautiful F&B team that we have out here, we are able to meet up with that. So, you know, having said that, the cliche food demands which are there of a guest, of course, we can meet that. But then our expertise here is to be able to meet those rare food demands.
So if you could just tell me something about your cuisine, that what all features do you have?
See, cuisine, any hotel does advertise their cuisine as saying that, we offer Indian or Oriental or Pan-Asian or Continental. I proudly say that I'm able to offer a lot of various Indian regional cuisines, which probably is a little difficult to find everywhere. For example, I recently had a Bihari and a Bengali wedding, so we had a lot of the lunches being made very typically in the Bengali and the Bihari style of food. I've had a Punjabi and a Christian wedding as well out here. So that's what I mean. So firstly, to be able to even suggest those things to a client, one needs to be very well prepared from his end to know and understand his culture and to then give him those food offerings. Once you know what needs to be made, it's easy to get that prepared. But if you don't know what's in the pipeline, then it's very difficult to even offer that.
So I see you have a lot of features, and you, possibilities that you give to your clients.
Of course.
So other than this, what all safety measures do you take for the customers?
Well, safety of being the first and foremost and the most important feature, not only of this hotel of mine, but we have got about 10 banquet halls of our own, and the MD of our company, Mr. Vikas Gutkutia, has taken all the extra measures, possible measures, to make sure that we adhere to all the safety norms in not only the hotel but all our banquet halls. And be it treating the sewage plants or following the Green Tribunal as to not using diesel gensets, to not using fire retardant fabric in our banquet halls, to treating the garbage, the wet and the dry garbage. It's endless. I mean, we even go to the extent of hiring a fire brigade and a fire tendering team for every function that we organize. So we are very stringent and we are very strict about our safety measures.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Thank you.